In the first exercise, you are going to complete with the superlative. You have options here, right? Just with superlative. Then, in the second game, I want you to choose between comparative or superlative. Remember that comparative is for two things and superlative is for three or more things. For example, my house is, this is the adjective I'm going to use, than yours. What do you think we need? Do we need a superlative or a comparative?
Comparative,
exactly, because I am comparing my house with your house. So what would be the option?
Bigger.
Okay, it's just this one. Ah, exactly. Good. And you are going to continue like that. And the last one, the tier one, it's a funny game where you have to hit. The correct superlative. Which one is correct? Is it correct? Which one is correct?
The happiest.
One.
Yeah, the happiest, but it's not here anymore. Again?
The fastest.
Fastest.
Yeah, that's correct. Exactly. You have to hit the animal with the correct superlative. Now tell me.
Happiest. Fastest. Biggest. También.
No, porque tenía una G.
No, the most.
Yeah. Okay. Porque tenía una G y biggest tiene que tener dos Gs.
Sí, ¿ya?
Okay, ya lo hacen en equipo. Yeah. You work in team. Do you understand what to do? Now, let's continue. Let's go to the conversation. That's freezing. That's freezing. Freezing, utilizamos esta expresión cuando algo está de muy, muy, muy frío, cuando algo congela. That's freezing. Si está fresco, decimos it's cool. Ahí rápidamente de repaso, decimos it's cool. Cool. Sorry. Si hace frío, cool es fresco. Pero si sentimos frío, entonces decimos it's cold. It's cold. Cold. Pero si hace demasiado frío, que hay nieve, entonces decimos it's freezing o that's freezing. Eso es demasiado frío. So, please, let's listen to this conversation and then we are going to practice it.
Station. That's freezing. Part A. Listen and practice.
Hi, Lily. You're from Canada, right? I'm going to Toronto in January.
Actually, I'm from the US, but I went to school in Toronto. Winter there can be pretty cold.
How cold is it on average?
I think the average in January is around 20 degrees or maybe 25 degrees.
25 degrees? But that's warm.
25 degrees Fahrenheit. That's about -3 or 4 Celsius.
-3 or 4? That's freezing.
Oh, come on. That's not so cold. At least not where I'm from.
Really? Where are you from?
Well, I live in Fairbanks, Alaska, around 3,000 miles from Toronto. That's, let me check on my phone. Yes, that's about 4,800 kilometers.
Wow. So is it colder than Toronto?
It's much colder than Toronto. It's the coldest city in the United States.
Okay, guys, I want you to practice this conversation. So we are going to go back to the breakout rooms now to practice this. Okay, let's see questions with how. It's a very easy grammar. Questions with how. Listen to the examples, and then we are going to check it. No, first let's check it. Questions with how. We can make a lot of questions with how plus adjectives. Here you have the questions we can make. How far? That would be ¿qué tan lejos? How far? ¿Qué tan lejos? How big? What do you think it means?
¿Qué tan grande?
¿Qué tan grande? Yes, how big? How high?
¿Qué tan alto?
¿Qué tan alto?
Yes. How deep?
¿Qué tan profundo?
¿Qué tan profundo?
Yes. How long?
¿Qué tan largo?
How hot?
¿Qué tan caliente?
How cold?
¿Qué tan frío?
Yes. And there are more. And there are more. For example, how large?
¿Qué tan grande?
¿Qué tan largo?
¿Qué tan grande? No, largo es long. ¿Qué tan grande o extenso? Recuérdense que long es de dos dimensiones y large es de tres. ¿Yes?
Profesor, en el audio anterior ocupó esta palabra para definir que era una universidad grande. Algo así.
Maybe.
Tuve la noción que dijo que la universidad era, dijo large.
Ya, yeah, maybe, sí lo puedes usar para sí, hablando de, porque una universidad tiene un terreno en tres dimensiones. Yes. Ya, yeah, could be, puede ser.
Creo que ocupó esa palabra. How large.
Okay. So, questions about how plus adjectives?
No.
Es how adjective, pronoun y verb, ¿se podría decir complemento?
It would be...
No.
How plus adjective. Y luego okay. Todo el verbo y lo que tengas que decir. Plus complement.
Ok, porque el sujeto se sustituye por el adjetivo, ¿no? Podría ser.
Ya, yeah, pero todos llevan is porque hablamos estamos utilizándolo para cosas de la naturaleza.
Okay.
Yes?
How deep is your love?
Let's see. Okay. That's all. No, it's very easy. So now listen the examples and then ask me if you have questions.
Page 96. Exercise 10. Grammar focus. Questions with how.
How cold is Toronto in the winter?
It gets down to minus 25 degrees Celsius, minus 13 degrees Fahrenheit.
How hot is Fairbanks in the summer?
It gets up to about 20 degrees Celsius, 68 degrees Fahrenheit.
How far is Toronto from Fairbanks?
It's about 4,800 kilometers, 3,000 miles.
How big is Seoul?
It's 605 square kilometers, 233.6 square miles.
How high is Mount Everest?
It's 8,848 meters high, 29,028 feet.
How long is the Mississippi River?
It's about 3,700 kilometers long, 2,300 miles.
How deep is the Grand Canyon?
It's about 1,828 meters deep, 6,000 feet.
Okay, guys, do you understand the questions and the answers?
Yes.
Okay, well, just to point out, get downs es como baja, hablando de temperatura, ¿sí? Baja hasta menos 25, dice aquí. Get up es sube. Get up to about 20 degrees. Tienen que llevar to. Get down to, bajar, y gets up to. And yeah, that's it, I think. And with hike, high, long, and deep, por lo regular se mencionan, se vuelven a mencionar en la respuesta. It's 8,848 meters high. Es 8,000 tantos de alto. It's about kilometers long. Tanto de largo. It's 1,828 meters deep. Es tanto de profundo. Estos tres en especial, estos tres adjetivos, se mencionan también en la respuesta. ¿Yes?
Profesor, ¿y en Seúl? ¿Qué tan grande es Seúl? Uh-huh. ¿Cuál es la respuesta?
Ah, es 605 kilómetros cuadrados. Square kilometers es kilómetros cuadrados.
Okay, thank
you. Ah, you're welcome. Okay, entonces, bueno, haciendo énfasis otra vez en lo del large, recuerden que esa es la diferencia. Cuando decimos big, solo estamos preguntando por largo y ancho. En este caso, por eso cuando digo how big es algo, qué tan grande es algo, estoy preguntando por los kilómetros cuadrados. ¿Sí? Nada más por esta superficie. Cuando ya utilizo large, incluyo el alto, largo, ancho y alto. Por eso en lo de la universidad yo así debió haber sido. Ah, the university is large, o it's a large university. Porque se refiere que no es grande nada más en perímetro, sino también en altura. ¿Yes? Que tiene varios edificios, que está alta. Okay, that's the difference.
Yes, teacher.
So, please, write the questions to the answers. Tienen las respuestas, hay que escribir las preguntas. Got it? Go, please. 2 minutes. Okay, so Jose, tell me, what's the answer for number one?
Me?
Yes.
Okay, how large is Niagara Falls?
No, because Niagara Falls es una son cascadas.
Pensé que grande, bueno, profundo.
Ay.
Sí, me lo imaginé como hiciste en tres dimensiones.
Ya. Y en el caso de las cascadas, lo relevante es que hasta qué altura tiene.
Profundo.
Tienen. No, qué altura tienen, sería how high. Yes. Porque está sobre la
superficie. Y no se puede utilizar deep tampoco.
No. No, porque la profundidad es a partir del agua hacia abajo. Pero en las cascadas lo importante es la caída, la altura. Caída de agua. Sí.
Ah, ok.
La respuesta marca que es con high. Uh-huh.
Ah, ya, yeah. Ahí está, well, tip, yes, that's correct. How high is or are?
Is Niagara Falls?
Is, exactly, sí, porque a pesar de que está en plural, falls, caídas, pero estamos hablando de una estructura natural, una cascada, es una. How high is Niagara Falls? Uh-huh. Then,
pero si hay casos donde puede llevar a profe.
Si fuera plural, sí. Si hablaras de varios ríos, por ejemplo, en general, en plural de algo. Pero es poco común que preguntes qué tan largos son los ríos tal y tal. ¿Ya? Ahí tendría que ser how long are the rivers, the Nilo and the Danubio rivers. En plural sí tendría que ser. Got it?
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
Hugo.
Teacher.
Number two.
How big is California?
Okay, good. How big is California? Dulce, number three.
How long is the Nile?
How long is the Nile? Yes. Is the Nile River, por lo regular se menciona. How long is the Nile River? Ángel, number four.
Yes, teacher. How far is Osaka from Tokyo?
Yes, how far is Osaka from Tokyo? That's correct. And the last one, Oscar, number five. Oscar?
Sorry, sorry.
Number five?
Yeah, that's simple. How hot is Mexico City?
Okay, how hot is Mexico City?
In the summer, no?
Yes, in the summer. Yeah, because in the answer, they specify in the summer. Do you agree?
Yep, yes, teacher. Thank you, Marta.
No questions about the answers?
No, teacher.
Are you sure? Okay, there you have the answer. They are the same. How high, how big, how long, and how far and how hot is Mexico City in the summer. We have the same. No questions, are you sure? Well, that's great, because that would be all for today. Just let me give you the homework. The homework would be the last three pages. Just two of them. For homework, please answer in the workbook. Pages, well, yeah, page 82. Le sirve de lectura. Solamente está muy facilito, true or false. Page 82. 83, where you are going to practice the how plus adjective, and 84, where you are going to practice again the comparative and superlative. Please answer pages 82, 83, and 84. Yes? Got it?